if we have, say for instance, as I had asthma. So with asthma, the lower lungs are affected. But if the lower lungs are affected, your nose is affected. Because whatever inflammation happens in the lungs, it travels up to the nose, and whatever inflammation in the nose will travel down to the lungs. If you've got asthma, your lung function is reduced. And if you've got nasal obstruction, your sleep is affected. You're twice as likely to have sleep disorder breathing. Your sleep is affected, you wake up fatigued. If you've got asthma, or if you've got poor breathing patterns or breathing patterns disorder, you'll tend to breathe faster. If you breathe faster, it contributes to stress. It's not just people with asthma who have poor breathing patterns. It's very common, even with athletes. We looked at a paper published yesterday, 60 to 70% of people studied had poor breathing patterns. Now, that's a little bit shocking. But if you've got poor breathing patterns, it's affecting every function. Oftentimes, breathing is neglected, but yet breathing is the one function that imposes limits. In sports even, an athlete can push themselves, but it's usually breathing that will hold them back, that intense feeling of breathlessness. It's also through your breath that oxygen is delivered from the red blood cells to the cells. And how you breathe is going to influence that. Your blood circulation, your airways, and your oxygen delivery is influenced by how you breathe. And I'm going to say this, the ideas about breathing out there are not correct in the main. People, there's so many ideas out there about breathing. I cringe when I hear about them because people are putting out misinformation. And we have this belief in the Western world that it's good to take big breaths. It's good to breathe more, like everything else that we're doing. And what I want to do is show you the opposite. But I don't want to show it to you in theory. I want to show it to you in experience. Does that make sense? So, my asthma, within 1 week, after 20 years, it greatly diminished. I can't give you a figure 70%, but certainly wheezing, breathlessness, caught for breath, dramatically diminished. What did I do? I switched to nose breathing. And that's so simple. But my nose was constantly blocked, so I used the exercises to open up the nose. You can decongest your nose in 5 minutes by holding your breath. This has been known since 1923. Breath holding in man opens up the airways. How exactly is it happening? Not so sure, but we know it happens. You breathe through your nose, it improves your lung function. You improve your lung function, it improves your sleep. You breathe through your nose, you get the benefit of a gas called nitric oxide, sterilizes the air, and is a natural bronchodilator to open up your airways. So you have better breathing, your sleep is better. You've got better breathing because you've got less asthma or less breathing pattern disorder, your stress is better. So the people who are coming into us are stress, anxiety, panic attacks, sleep, snoring, insomnia, obstructive sleep apnea, children, craniofacial development, sports performance, which is another thing altogether, and of course then breathing. And that's what we're looking at. So we're looking at it from a health perspective and also from a sports perspective.